This is a worksheet full of equations. This is me attempting to solve a math problem and failing. This is me trying to be an IT nerd, somebody who could be smarter, and still fail as the IT nerd. A common question asked around the cybersecurity community, and especially students, is how much math is needed in cybersecurity? The answer is, of course, it depends. It depends on the type of cybersecurity position you want to potentially aspire to become or you want to transition into. It totally is dependent. You may not even know what that position is right now. I mean, you're a student maybe someone in a career transition. You have no idea what kind of cybersecurity position you want to become or want to transition into in 20 years. So let me go ahead and address this question with the fundamental basis behind what you'll need in math, and then we can transition into the type of cybersecurity positions that need more advanced math and that don't need as many advanced math. Hello everyone, my name is Grant. Hello everyone, my name is Grant. I am a aspiring cybersecurity professional trying to help you in your learning process here. A common question asked, very common, is how much math is required for cybersecurity? I think it's a big fear of students right now is, I'm just not very good at math, so I can't do careers in cybersecurity or IT security itself. Let me go ahead and start with two potential scenarios you're in, right? So you're gonna be a student who's potentially looking into a formal accredited college degree. A lot of students who ask, how much math or whether the math course is required, often are students that are going to be enrolling or are actually completing a cybersecurity degree or any degree related to information technology. And then number two, the potential scenario you could be in is you're not going to college. You're doing another route, maybe formal qualifications through certifications, or just self-study. It could be anything. Now, this may not help you as much because I'm going to be addressing more of the courses, but it still could help you find the type of positions that you will need more advanced math knowledge. So with these assumptions behind us, let me go ahead and address this question head on. Let's tackle this. Exactly what courses, which subjects in math do you really need to be knowledgeable in, or at least have somewhat of a knowledge in success in to complete a degree or to be successful in a job? These courses or math topics or whatever you want to call them include statistics, algebra, pre-calculus, physics. Now, this may be a science, but you have some simple mathematical calculations and engineering fundamentals. These are the courses you will most likely see universally among most information technology, computer science, cybersecurity, information security, degrees or curriculums itself. But for example, let's say you are a computer science major, right? You're going to need to know calculus. In fact, you're not just going to have to know just pre-calculus or algebra. You're going to have to be into calculus 1 and 2. Most curriculums require, computer science specifically, require calculus 2 as their advanced math classes. So it is totally dependent on the type of major or degree you want to pursue. But let's focus on cybersecurity specifically, right? Because this channel addresses the cybersecurity perspective. And as the cybersecurity degrees continue to, I guess, emerge into the markets or the platform, we're going to see more and more commonalities among what real cybersecurity degrees are looking for. So cybersecurity degrees, or whatever your institution will call them, you know, the buzzword or whatever it is, they're going to have math included, most likely, right? They're going to have some basic fundamental classes, some basic math classes included and incorporated. And that, as I just outlined, was those fundamental courses in math subjects. So, okay, let's say you get past your cybersecurity degree and you have those fundamentals down, those fundamental courses with those expectations of succeeding, surpassing those classes, right? So you earn your cybersecurity degree. The next best question is, well, what type of position do you want to go into? So some cybersecurity positions are really going to require a lot more math-heavy, math knowledge, mathematical expressions, things of that nature. They're going to require more than others, right? So let me go ahead and give you an example of a cybersecurity position that's going to really require math, or multiple of them, right? So these are going to include computer science-ish, I know that's computer science-ish majors or positions with a security perspective or security focus. So like a secure software developer, a security software developer, or a security code auditor. Those are going to be like three positions that you're really going to have more of a math knowledge. You need more math. You need to understand the logical principles behind computer science, and that includes math. If you haven't checked out my programming series and you're looking to be a programmer in cybersecurity, I recommend that you check that out. Link in the description below. So if math is not your best, strongest subject, that's okay, because in fact, there's many roles in cybersecurity that really don't require this deep, heavy knowledge of math. You know, these could include like managerial. Is that even a word? Managerial. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but these include managers, right? So managers are not going to be so math heavy. But these also can include other cybersecurity positions. So in fact, a lot of cybersecurity positions, whether you want to be a security code auditor or a secure software developer, or you want to become a penetration tester, we're going to have you start out with a cybersecurity analyst, right? And so from a cybersecurity analyst, you can move on into and deviate into the position that you want to after a few years of experience. So anyway, so cybersecurity analysts are going to be one of the concrete ones that don't need tons of math. Also, junior vulnerability assessor, right? And even some manager assistant to the security manager. Those would be some more not as math heavy, math focused positions in cybersecurity. This is okay. Now this is I know that I just had that expression, but a lot of people think cybersecurity is about ethical hacking, penetration testing, or just hacking in general. So let's just go ahead and address this head on with ethical hacking, penetration testing, right? It's so popular now that people just want to know how much math will you need? You're going to need some math knowledge. Really, you're going to have to know scripting if you're going to be a penetration tester. I mean, you're going to need scripting if you're going to be a cybersecurity analyst. But let me just go ahead and give you this right now. For penetration testing, ethical hacking, whatever you want to call it, most people, most vendors or most companies look for skill. You know, you have to think like a hacker when it comes to penetration testing. So no, not a ton of math is going to be required, but it does require a certain amount of skill. There you go. I just answered the question head on for all of you aspiring ethical hackers. Hey, I'm an aspiring ethical hacker too, right? No, just jumping on. Okay, yeah. Really need to move on. All right, so anyway, you need to know exactly what position you need to go into today, right? No, you don't. You can have, you have time to explore the industry and understand, you know, where you are really good or where you are really interested in the cybersecurity field. Something that's awesome about the cyber field itself. Likely, you're going to start out being an entry-level cybersecurity analyst, right? So you're going to be somebody who's just doing a lot of an array of multiple tasks. That could include some scripting, some auditing, some policy documentation, incident response. It can include all of that in one, right? It depends on what your position is, but you're going to start out as a cybersecurity analyst. And from there, you can deviate into the certain positions, interests, skills that you want to within the cybersecurity community and industry. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please share. And that's only my intent, is just to help you. So thank you very much for watching and have a good day.